10. Summary.
Welcome to the Info Products section of the course, where we'll be getting more specific and expanding on the successes you already had in the previous sections on product creation. One reason why we're going to be looking at info products in particular is that they're quick, easy, and cheap to produce, and a single good info product can make bucket loads of cash.
If you know something, you can sell that knowledge. It's open to anyone and everyone.
Firstly, I want to say, even if you're not creating info products, take a read, and you may find that you come up with info product ideas for future products. Just because you may not be creating an info product, the principles are the same for any product out there. Just so we don't get confused as to what's happening here, let me put your mind at rest. We're going to look at why most marketers' info products flop, and without going into writing class mode, I'm going to give you a simple, quick and easy step-by-step checklist for successfully creating an info product that's dripping with quality and saleability. If the moment someone says info product to you, a picture of a cliché substandard ebook comes to mind, keep reading, because I'm going to show you just how interesting an info product can become. Let's begin by looking at why exactly you'd want to create an info product. For a start, they're versatile from the point of view of the product creator, you. Second, it requires little investment money-wise, because all you're paying for is hosting, and maybe some graphics for your site if you don't want to do them yourself. With such low overheads, it's one of the most ideal and well-suited product a marketer can create when starting out. Third, it's easy to come up with ideas for info products. Like we mentioned earlier, if you know how to avoid something, or get something that you want, and you can write, or even dictate and have someone write for you, you can create an info product. Let's talk about exactly what I mean when talking about info products, and show you what kind of opportunities they give with regards to the way that the presentation of them can vary. Many people are creating info products that are out of date and unimaginative, and it's hurting their sales badly. If you've been online for a while, you're probably bored of the word ebook already, and you can often see references to this in sales letters.
Fed up of all those boring out-of-date ebooks, for example. The concept of the ebook is old and tired, and even though some still sell well, I believe that anything called an ebook can be sold much more effectively without changing its content. Let me ask you, given the choice, would you buy Mr. X's all-knowing ebook that costs $500, or would you buy a product advertised as revealing a specific, proven and profitable sales method, presented as an 8-week intensive marketing course delivered in full audio for the ease and speed of your learning, spread over 5 CDs, packed full of bonuses and personal one-to-one consultation to make sure that you succeed? What I'm trying to demonstrate is that when you create an info product, look at how you're going to deliver and present it. Try to stay away from the standard ebook approach. It doesn't cost a lot to do, and you'll find that it's easier to sell your product at the price it deserves rather than spending 6 months writing a really valuable piece of kit that reveals all your secrets, only to have to sell it for a measly $10 and undervalue yourself just because no one wants another boring old ebook.
Rule number one of creating info products.
Allow yourself to charge what you feel your product is worth by coming up with new, mixed, and diverse methods of presentation.
You're not scamming anyone here.
You're creating a premium product. Look at this way, why do seminars and consultations cost thousands and sometimes tens of thousands of dollars to attend, when the information is likely already contained somewhere in a $20 product? Why do universities charge thousands of dollars per term to go over there and get taught when all the information is contained within $50 textbooks anyway? It's the same information, you're just paying for the presentation and any names, reputations, experiences, and guarantees that come with that particular course or seminar.
One more point before we move along. Info product doesn't mean single sale.
Just know for now that you have a choice, and once you start looking at audio, video, and information, coupling that with membership sites, the floodgates really open for variations in presentation for your own products. Okay, so we've looked at single sales, membership, and premium publications and shown you how to add value to an info product beyond the standard ebook approach. Let's look now at how diverse and versatile info products become with just a little thought.
There is one type of info product I'd like to talk to you about right now, and that's upsell products.
Products sold at a low price to entice the customer to go out and buy a higher-priced follow-up.
When done successfully, this is a powerful technique, but when done incorrectly, it'll kill customer confidence in you forever. Ever purchased an info product that's an upsell? I sure have.
Ever bought an info product that totally sucked and didn't give any of the info it promised because it was just a cheap excuse to get you to buy more stuff at 20 times the price?
I've had that also.
Practically every single upsell that I've bought has been terrible.
I want you to know when I say upsell, I mean real products giving real information that are real helpful and do as advertised.
Still with the intention of selling people on, but the upsell is a real solid product in itself.
There is nothing wrong at all with this type of marketing. In fact, when done with pride, some of these upsells can become quality products indeed and rake in a whole bunch of cash at the same time.
Done incorrectly, however, check out the BBB definition of bait selling, and you'll see there's a fine line that must not be crossed when looking at this subject.
The next rule of info product creation is don't think of it as a bonus.
Charge what you believe it to be worth.
We already talked about how you can devalue yourself and your product just through poor and unimaginative presentation.
Keep in mind when you create your products, using your mind and your knowledge, they are valuable, real valuable.
Don't just go selling for $20 because someone told you to, or you see others doing that.
Only your tracking data can tell you the facts here.
Add a pinch of fresh variance into the presentation, and feel confident about putting $200, $500, $1,000 price tags on your products.
You didn't put in all that effort and creation, knowledge sharing, and bonus giving to charge $10, did you?
I highly doubt it.
Putting the price up on a product can actually increase sales.
When I first launched my original site for $10 a month,
I wanted to have the best site at the best price, and agreed, some of the customers were only there because I was the cheapest around.
I'd put my all into this site though, and decided that it was worth more, if not just for the positive feedback I was getting, so I added an extra $15 to the price tag.
Lo and behold, with the same marketing methods I'd learned in my very limited experience, my profits went from $150 a week up to almost $300 a week in the same time it took me to pull in that $150 a week worth of members.
That's excluding any current members I had pay me $130 for a yearly membership up front.
Nothing changed, but the price.
So in this case, a 50% increase in the price meant a 100% increase in sales.
Cool, huh?
Back then I had no answer to why are you putting your price up, aside from it being an experiment.
It soon became clear though that undervaluing is as devastating as charging too much for too little.
Be confident, charge what it's worth, not what you think people will be willing to pay.
You might find yourself surprised, and if not, there's nothing stopping you from changing it back.
You are in total control of your business after all.
I also want to tell all those of you out there that want to write reports on online marketing, there's still space for you.
Just because there's a bunch of people out there right now selling stuff that mildly resembles setting up a serious business online, doesn't mean that you can't break into this highly competitive market.
Just because there's a lot out there, it doesn't make them all good. It's up to you to connect with your market and make your info product the best work you've ever done, and inspire people to listen to you in an interesting way.
There are four types of people out there.
The first can't be bothered.
They bought their info product, and a week or two later send emails asking for refunds before they've even finished, or even started, reading and taking action on the information.
Type 2 will read the reports in full, get excited about much money they're now dreaming about earning, and how their newfound knowledge will make them rich.
Unfortunately, they never put anything into action and wonder why they never get anywhere.
They'll put it down to the quality of the site and move on looking for the next best thing.
The type 3 person I have all the time in the world for.
They read, they learn, and they put it into action in a serious manner.
These are the people that are going to be a success.
They go away, follow the instructions, and come out on top.
They got what they wanted, and the writer of the info product got a reputation boost and possible a new contact.
Type 4 are those who are successful already.
They already know everything, they're just looking for new inspiration through guides, and that's something that I personally do, and I'm happy to spend a lot of cash on stuff that inspires me, even if I know about all the concepts contained within already.
These are just some of the reasons why there will be a market for info products for a long time to come.
Understand that even though it might be a way off into the future, especially if the product you're creating right now isn't information-based, keep in mind that you'll get these four groups visit you at some point or another.
Good, a great base of knowledge there for you, most of it relating to all businesses rather than just information publishers. Above all though, if there's something I want you to remember, it's that no matter what your product, charge what you believe it to be worth. Only your tracking and testing can tell you for sure if you were right to do so. Your new info product doesn't have to land in the pile of millions of failed and rejected $10 bonuses. It can be a shining example of a quality, high-ticket, premium item. Take only this into account and you increase your chances of success dramatically. 11. Goals of this section. To lay down some specific pointers for writing your own info product. To delve into what people want from your info products and how to make them read it. To show you how to keep things interesting for the readers. To talk to you about knowledge bases and why most people fail to create any wealth from the sales of info products. To show your customers that you mean business, and to build their trust, and in turn, earn you a load more cash. To lay down pointers for you allowing yourself to give your product a twist and make it stand out from the boring droll and cliche products already crowding our inboxes and search results. To demonstrate how to plug your other products and services in your information product effectively, without annoying any of your customers to the point of no one buying your stuff a second time around. To introduce some additional elements that could easily turn your single sale info product into a monster-sized project, with several offshoots, creating multiple streams of income. 12. Profitable info products too. Alright, here we go. So why the heck should you listen to me? What could I possibly know about writing info products and how to get people to read them, what to put in them, and so on? Well, aside from this site obviously, my previous site nicknamed The Big Experiment from now on also had an info section. Now granted, it wasn't as long or nearly as detailed as the complete set of these manuals, and it's showing its age after being up and running for 3 years, but see, with this site I ran all sorts of experiments and tested out all sorts of ideas, from pricing, to follow-up, to lead generation, sales letters, ad copy, commissions, bonuses, presentation, and I even tested testing itself at many points throughout its life. You name it, I tested it. Each time I tested a section and found something that was pretty astounding, or something that showed significant results, I went ahead and wrote about it. I showed people what I tested, where I tested, why I thought the results would occur, and whether or not they did. This spawned the start of my info product writing, and several manuals and results pages went to members just for testing's sake. How could I get them to read and trust what I was saying? How could I get them to take notice and actually do what I was saying? What content was safe to include, where, and why? Should I promote other stuff? If so, how? Once again, as you can see, many testing parameters. I don't have a degree in copywriting. I'm not a language expert, or anything like that, but nothing beats the real-world experience I had, which started so long ago. This should instantly tell you two things. 1. I can trust this guy, he's already got my money, and he wants me to buy his new stuff when he releases it too. Couple that with a lot of real-world experience, I know I'm not being screwed. 2. If I can do it, you can do it. Like I said, no special qualifications, just experience, which is exactly what I'm going to pass on to you now. So you don't have to spend years making people read your stuff to find out what works and what doesn't, and instead, use that extra time to make more money, more quickly. 12b. Keep it interesting to keep them reading. So without further ado, let's get started, and the first number one most important thing that I can think of when you're writing is to keep things interesting. Vary things a lot. Don't just list off a load of factual information. That's boring, and no matter how right you are, or how insightful you are, if your readers are bored to death, you're not helping them at all, and in return they just won't buy or read your stuff again. Look at your presentation, keep it structured, but interesting. Titles, subtitles, and bullet points are great, and it's far nicer to look at a clearly structured page like that than a massive long ream of tedious text. I know it sounds like something a schoolteacher might tell you, or lecture you about how you're not presenting your work well, but it's true, and something I live by. Imagine if I took this course that you're taking right now, removed all the bullets and titles, and just placed the whole set of manuals in a PDF file and sold it like that. Would you seriously be willing to read a 1200-page ream of text? I sure wouldn't, no matter how good it is. Throw in a couple of stories to demonstrate what you're talking about. It's far easier for the reader to get the idea about what you're saying if you show them in a way they can relate to, especially when it's presented as a real-world experience. Some real simple steps, but seriously, something that's so important. If no one's reading your product, no matter how many you sell, it's a waste of time. 12c. Know it before you write it. Here comes the fun part. Know what you're talking about. If you don't, it'll show, people will laugh, tell other people, and your reputation will be insta-ruined. Make sure you're successful in your field before writing. If you're writing about how to catch a shed load of fish every time you hit the riverbank, make sure you can and do actually do this yourself before telling anyone else how to do it. I've seen so many poor excuses for info products. Not taking into account the length or quality of the site or sales letters, etc., but just on the basis of the info contained within them, and it's no wonder people are confused and going out of their minds about how to do stuff, and not only in the world of online business. I've got so many examples of this, it's worrying, but I'll just land one on you quickly. A friend of mine comes over one night for a drink. She's a part of an online game, you know, the ones where there are thousands of people playing all at once, each one vying to be the best on the server. Anyway, she started talking about her game, and proceeded to tell me that she'd bought an info product on how to be successful, and become one of the rich that can buy pretty much whatever items they want. So she drags me over the computer, brings the site up, and shows me the info. Oh dear, how poor it was. It was a basic copy of the instruction manual that apparently comes with the game anyway, and didn't give away any useful information at all. I proceeded to tell her she should have known by the domain, but that's not the point. The product was shoddy, and he plainly had no idea what he was talking about. That's an outside the online marketing world example, but if you've been around for any amount of time, I'm sure if we got together and talked about crap info products written by people who had no idea what they're talking about, we'd be there all week. Unfortunately, the same is true for online marketing. I've seen people teaching the most basic stuff and advertising it as online marketing reports. Like we don't already know how to send email, give us a break. Creating info products is not an easy task in the first place, especially ones of any size, but make sure you know the full story. If a professional in your field, the best fisherman, the most famous actor, the highest earning online marketer came to you and wanted to read your stuff, would you be embarrassed to show them it? If so, it's probably best to do a little bit more research and testing before getting down to the creation of your product. Your customers and your pockets will love you for it. 12D, don't just know it, show it. Alright, so know what you're talking about is pretty basic and pretty obvious. So let's get to something that I see missing all the time, and I'm going to take a guess and be pretty confident you've seen this too, and that show that you know what you're talking about. So important, but hardly anyone does it. Why are you showing people how to do something? Have you done this before successfully? Can you prove it? Do you have the experience to be schooling people about your subject? Can you prove it? Do your methods work? Can you prove it? It's all about inspiring confidence. See, the problem is, even if someone comes along and buys your product without actually hearing anything about what you've done in the past, your success stories, testimonials about how your methods work, they'll read through, and no matter how great it is, they'll come to the end, and they'll be left wondering if your stuff really works. That's exactly why everything I write is packed with examples, and previous experiences, and real-life encounters. I like to show you this stuff works, where it works, and how it works in a way that everyone can relate to. It's easy to do, and all it means is your customers are going to come to you, hand you their cash for your product, read it, be interested by it, and by the end, they're going to feel like they've actually learned something that they can apply to whatever subject it is you might be talking to them about. There's so many ways you can do this: snippets of your bank account, the hits to your website, your list of contacts, the success of your products, previous and present, stories from the past told in a way that people can relate to and say, "Hey, yeah, I know exactly what you mean," testimonials from other people that your customers trust, photos of that big haul of fish you caught and regularly catch each trip, the list goes on. Use your imagination, provide proof in an interesting, non-stuck-up way, and people will provide you with all their attention and more. Don't forget to do this regularly in your reports. No matter how good your sales letter is, if your product doesn't enforce that you know what you're talking about, don't expect any repeat business from the most important people of all. Your long-term customers willing to actually pull their wallets out and spend their money on the quality products that you create. 12e, enjoy it. Rule 4, enjoy the heck out of it. If you're writing about it, you have to enjoy it. If you do, it'll show through and your readers will know it. Coupled with the examples above, you can take a standard drab report and turn it into something amazing, inspiring, fact-packed and interesting that your customers will love you for. Like I said earlier, it's good to be professional about your work. If you're enjoying it, the work you produce will be so much better. Many people nowadays do stuff for the sake of it, and to make money out of it, but it's so clear in the quality and presentation of their work that they don't enjoy it. And remember, that's why you're here, right? To give yourself a little freedom, more cash, knowledge, and insight. You have to enjoy the journey rather than look at the goals and push yourself on because you really want to make a bucket load of cash. Now personally, I love the business game, and I love writing and talking about it, which is why I'm here. It's no good shattering yourself and boring yourself to death just for the goal of the extra cash, because quite simply, you're defeating the object of reaching that goal by making yourself, and most likely your customers, unhappy. Not good. Enjoyment is one of the primary reasons for creating products as well. If you enjoy it, you're going to do it well. If you do this particular activity, you'll get to know it better and come up with even more ideas. Most importantly, don't feel that you're limiting yourself or stunting your potential income by not releasing an online marketing product. That's not true at all, even though it may feel it if you've been in the game for a long time. 12F, give it a twist. Whatever you're writing, give yourself some identity. Something that defines you against the gray background of other marketers or competition out there. It'll make people remember you, and it'll stand out as something new, something innovative, and something that people will want to buy and use. It also suggests that it's an organized plan, which is definitely a plus. People don't want to be bogged down by random unstructured information that jumps about all over the place. Now, I talked about this earlier in the product creation reports, so I won't go back into that here. Just keep it in mind. It's a real fundamental of a good, recognizable, and successful info product. 12G, plugging done correctly. Rule 6. We've got a little something for you that no one seems to have a definitive answer on. Should you plug other products and services through your info products, and if so, how? Well, the simple answer is yes, you sure should. If you don't, you're wasting valuable customers that may just enjoy your product so much, they head off to buy another one, putting even more cash in your pocket. The problem is, how do you plug other products inside info products effectively without annoying the heck out of the readers? Well, first and foremost, this is kind of a gray area. A little like upselling that we talked about earlier. If you mention this method to someone in conversation, they'll give you funny looks and shy away, simply because this has such a bad name, due to the poor products out there that are just excuses for an advert. So the first thing I will say, create a product for the creation of the product and make it good. Don't create a product to be an advert. Whether it's free or paid, if you start talking to someone about this great new tactic you've learned, they take their time to listen to you or read your stuff, and by the end it's just an extended sales pitch. Don't expect to be very popular or leave a good taste in people's mouths. I've seen a lot of methods and different ways that people advertise their stuff inside paid and free info products. Some of them you can instantly see through common sense that they're not doing much for the writer, and on the other hand, some of them are excellent and complement the product very well. So here's what I suggest. The next time you write an info product, whether it be paid or free, talk about your previous experiences with some of your other products. This is especially easy with online marketing, shows your customers what other stuff you've done, without annoying the heck out them because your product is a poor excuse for an advert. Second up, find a way to link your sites and products at the end. For example, if I wanted to plug some of my other products here, I wouldn't write a whole guide that was based around that product working, or what people thought of it, but you can bet your life I'll let you know about them either at the end, or refer to it in my examples. Another method that works extremely well is to write sections that relate to your other products, but you have to reveal something and give good info at the same time, because if you don't, again missing the big key here, your info product will turn into another glorified advert. So here's the general rule. Do you plug other products in your free and paid products? Yes, you do, but you do it in a way that doesn't take away from the original aims of the info product and the information it promises to give. The reason you'll hear and see people not doing this is because they're worried about what their customers and readers are going to think. The fact is, as long as your product does the job it set out to do, and what you told the buyers or readers it will do, you can refer to affiliate links, your own site's links, whatever. Just make sure the product does the job.
12H, inject your own personality.
Rule 7, and probably the least used of them all.
Inject your own personality into what you're writing.
People like to be entertained, even when they're learning serious business-like stuff.
Don't be afraid to talk to your customers like you would your friends, because not only are you likely to enjoy the writing and find it easier to flow, but the reader will have a much more enjoyable experience, and of course is more likely to remember you.
One thing to be careful of here though, when you're writing, try to avoid things like sarcasm and irony, because I can tell you from previous experience, different people have different understandings of such things. It can lead to misunderstandings and big problems, especially when the facts aren't clear.
Interest people, sure, but don't confuse the heck out of them, because they might not know what you're talking about, even if it seems obvious to you.
12. I keep your language mainstream.
Finally, try to keep your language mainstream.
Now I'm from England, and sometimes have a problem with this.
I remember writing the sentence "it works a treat" in one of my sales letters, meaning that the method I was explaining works well.
It seems that this turned out to be a problem, as one of my good friends from over in the US totally misunderstood what I was saying, and a slightly different meaning of this popped into his head.
So whilst you're writing, remember to keep things fact-based, very structured, professional, and insert your own personality in there a little, without using slang words, or things that people from abroad might misunderstand, or even worse, just not understand at all.
12J, sell yourself.
Rule number 9.
Selling your products isn't the only thing you're doing inside Info Products. Don't forget to sell yourself.
Let your readers know who you are, where you've been, what you've seen or experienced, because in the long run, not only will they have much more belief in your work, but they'll elevate you in their minds and consider you a more trustworthy and a reliable source. And I don't need to tell you how important that is.
So there we have it.
8 basic rules that you can follow when writing your info products, ranging from increasing your reputation and how much people trust you, to actually getting people reading and taking action and talking about your product, how not to annoy the heck out of your customers and plug yourself effectively.
That's all I can do.
Give you the basic rules to follow, and let you follow them.
I would love to give you more, but I can't do that, simply because I have no idea what you're going to be writing about, I have no idea what your product is, and I have no idea about your writing style or your personality.
One thing I can be sure of, if you follow the above basic rules to a T, don't deviate from them at all, you'll end up with a good solid product based on your knowledge of your chosen subject, and your customers are more likely to actually read it, finding out all sorts about your previous experiences, your previous products, and really stomping your name and personal brand in their minds, ready for future follow-up products.
12K, and finally, I want to further reinforce what can be done with your product once you've been selling it for a while.
This is a great move to get some cash quickly, when you need it, and that's to sell resale rights.
Not just the normal resale rights though, oh no.
The majority of resale stuff out there is useless garbage that's 20 years old and is being given away for free anyway.
If you really want to get noticed when you put your info product up for sale with resale rights, put a high price tag on it and set some rules.
See, people who don't know how to come up with new product ideas like us now, swarm all over these things.
Not only that though, people that don't want to go to the trouble of setting up their own products, or people that just want a hassle-free, everything done for them, ready-to-go product to add to their lines.
If you want a successful resale rights info product, the method is simple.
Set rules as to how much it can be sold for so it doesn't devalue in price, set a number of copies to be sold to something low, around the 500 and downwards mark, set a no auction sites rule for the same devaluation reason, and there we have it.
2 products out of 1.
A high-ticket resale, and a high-ticket info product.
One word of warning, you might want to wait a little before you do this, because if someone real good gets their hands on your products, and they're targeting the same market as you, as big as the internet is, you're going to lose a wad of cash.
So there we have it.
An outline, and a basic rule set for creating info products and getting the most out of them.
It's not rocket science by any means, but there was no way that I'd be leaving this section out just because it sounds commonsensical to some people.
As far as this course goes, if it's important, if it works, and makes you more contacts, gets you customers and puts more money in your pocket at the end of the day, it's in.
Simple as.
13. Summary.
I want to give you a little more info about where what I'm relaying to you came from, and why no matter what you think of us personally, you should be taking note of the methods being taught so far and from here on in. So here I am writing this product right now, but previously, one of my exploits involved a rather hefty membership site that consisted of admin and automation software, but later in its life a section on online marketing, which could be placed in the info product category. Granted, it wasn't as detailed as this and it's now showing its age, but that site was nicknamed by myself and a few of my contacts that were paying attention to what I was doing at the time, the big experiment. Each time I tested a section, I found something that showed significant results, and went ahead and wrote about it. What was tested, where it was tested, why I thought the results would occur, and whether or not they did. This marked the beginning of my info product writing. Several members only tracking results and general marketing knowledge pages followed. Through this experience, I learned more than any book could have taught me at the time, and it's this tried and tested info that I'm passing to you right now, not some made-up stuff I threw together as a cheap excuse to sell something. How could I get them to trust what I was saying? How could I get them to take notice and take action? What content should I include and exclude, where and why? Should I promote my other stuff in the content, and how should I be doing this? I don't have a degree in copywriting, but just that short list off the top of my head is the type of real-world experience, tried and tested means, methods and testing parameters I'm showing you here. After all, I want you to come back and buy more of my stuff later. I want you to tell people about the positive experiences you've gained from my products, and make sure that you reach your goals at the same time. It's this experience and the situation we're both in right now that should tell you that anything in this report or any other is real, proven, and there for one reason and one reason only. To get your business up and running in a quick, profitable, no BS way. So let's continue to talk about the specifics of physically creating an info product. Rule number 1. Keep it interesting. Look at your presentation, keep it structured, use short sharp points and bullets if creating summaries. Vary your methods. A ream of text is tedious. A ream of text complemented by several different structure layouts, diagrams, tasks and methods of presentation such as audio and video will have people sit up, take notice, remember you and most importantly, not be bored out of their skull reading your stuff. Imagine what this product would look like if we removed everything but the text from the full manual set. Over 1,000 pages, one big block of text. I sure would find that hard to read, never mind follow and take action. Throw in stories and examples at every turn. Not only to add to the trust factor, but to keep people reading, to keep it interesting, and like we did above, snap people out of a routine. Rule number 2. Always know what you're talking about. I've seen so many poor info products, which at the time I didn't know gave incorrect or uneducated information until I found my own path and discovered they were incorrect and actually counterproductive. It's no wonder people are confused as heck trying to simply start their own business that makes them money on the net. Creating an info product of any size and quality isn't easy work, but it can be fun and extremely rewarding. If you know your stuff, not only will you sell more, inspire trust and make a bunch of cash short term, but also people are going to come back to you again and again. If your customers love it, and you really did solve their problems through knowledgeable writing, it's going to give you a heck of a lot of promotion power and reputation for future products. Rule number 3. Prove that you know what you're talking about. Why are you showing people how to get or avoid something? Show through examples and demonstrate that you've been there and how you fixed your problem and found the best solutions. Talk to your readers about why things happened as well as how. A how report is all good. But when times change as quickly as in the modern world, it isn't worth much without adding the whys too, allowing your customers to adapt your methods in the future, making your product even more valuable. Snippets of your bank account if you're claiming to be a millionaire and showing people how to get there too, pack it with real-life experiences and examples, get other people to say good stuff about you through standard testimonials, not for your sales letter, but within your product itself. This is important when trying to spur your readers into action and inspire them. You don't want them to go away telling people your stuff doesn't work, when actually the info is there, but you failed to inspire them and spur them into action. Rule number 4. Enjoy what you're doing and writing about. If you're not enjoying it, it will show in your work, and you won't be inspiring anyone, let alone your customers and readers. Remember why you're here, back to those original questions. Why are you here? My guess most said money, but also freedom, enjoyment, control, making earning money not a job, but a joy. This is made impossible if you don't enjoy your chosen subject to the max.
Rule number 5. Give it a twist. Give yourself some identity so that people remember you.
The frantic fishing catch more fish today intensive training course, the millions in minutes marketing system, for example.
These are very basic examples off the top of my head. Try to avoid the word system too. It's the ultimate cliche today, almost as bad as ebook or fire your boss.
Be creative, make people take notice, talk about you and remember you.
Rule number 6, plug your other stuff through your products.
Remember, make sure that your products are quality and do what they advertised.
If you do this, there's no problem with plugging your other stuff inside them, and this works extremely well when talking about previous experiences, and you can plug your other stuff in an indirect manner.
Rule number 7. Inject your own personality.
People like to be entertained, make the odd joke here and there, but don't go overboard.
Avoid the use of inverted commas and be specific, avoid sarcasm and the potential to be misunderstood, but inject your own personality, tell a joke, talk as if you were talking to friends in a relaxed, non-threatening manner.
Every individual is different, and this is a great way of making your product stand out both from a memory and sales perspective without too much effort.
Rule number 8. Sell yourself and your brand in your product.
Let readers know who you are, what you've seen and experienced, and why you're an authority figure on your chosen subject matter.
This will go further towards having people listen and take action on your experiences, helping themselves and in return your reputation and your pocket.
There we have it, the top 8 rules for creating your very own info product.
These are surefire rules that you can follow when creating all sorts of information-based selling tools and products.
Use this as an outline and a basic rule set for creating info products and getting the most out of them.
It's not rocket science by any means, but there was no way that I'd be leaving this section out just because it sounds commonsensical to some people.
As far as this course goes, if it's important, if it works, and makes you more contacts, gets you customers and puts more money in your pocket at the end of the day, which is good.